The Earth as seen from the International Space Station. When it turns night, the lights betray the planet's inequalities. Hundreds of millions have no electricity to turn on lights.
Globally, 840 million people still have no access, period. Of those, about two-thirds live in sub-Saharan Africa. So that comes to about 540 million people. Now, in a continent of less than a billion people, I mean, we've made progress over the last 15, 20 years, but it definitely could be a lot better.
And Africa is rapidly changing. Over the next decade, an additional 187 million Africans are projected to live in cities. The signs of urbanization can be found everywhere. Construction is booming, new industries are growing. Africa's young population shares the same desires as its peers around the world. But where will Africa get its energy from? Building energy infrastructure is costly and financial resources are already stretched. At times, governments set electricity tariffs too low, making investments less attractive. And investors are risk averse.
It's not impossible. I mean, there are no, you know, impossible is nothing.
And indeed, since early 2019, Africa is home to the world's largest solar power plant, occupying a 6 by 6 kilometers space in the Egyptian desert. Proof that the continent can overcome obstacles through a web of international cooperation.
And we're talking about roughly $2 billion of financing coming into Egypt to unleash the solar resource in the country with a combination of many international investors coming in for the very first time into Egypt. That should show the path for rest of Africa in terms of what can be achieved. But you need the drive and the environment to push to make sure that the resources are mobilized in the right way.
And soon there will be another record-breaking facility in Africa. In early 2019, construction of the Nachtigal project started, a hydropower plant in Cameroon that will deliver a third of the country's energy needs. It is the largest privately financed project of its kind ever.
You can't finance such large projects on your own. We clubbed together 15 lenders. 15 lenders, think about the amount of coordination work. But there is a broader picture to that, which is that IFC is not only a financier. IFC is also part of the World Bank group. And we have colleagues at the World Bank who are also engaging with the government to work on regulation, sector reform, because sector sustainability is absolutely critical to the sustainability of the projects themselves.
And there is the case of Zambia, which now enjoys more energy independence since IFC organized an auction for the scaling solar project, resulting in the lowest solar power tariffs in Africa to date.
In the case in Zambia, you're seeing the kind of capacity that it would take countries 50 years to deliver, being delivered through one transaction, and that is able to address government's concern in extremely quick timeframes, 2 years and less.
And there's another hallmark of IFC energy projects, sharing benefits with the local population, granting the social license to operate.
Social license means that in addition to this legal licenses and permits, company needs to have local acceptance for the project to be there and continue to operate.
Example, Benban Solar Park in Egypt. The operation has integrated itself into the local community, creating jobs directly and indirectly. The next decades will not only bring more electric power to Africa, they will bring empowerment.